Awesome. Bineshi e zeti e zoyaha keda anishinabe ze sho dasen. Oklahoma e dochene IEN kado kae. My name is Bineshi Albert. I'm Yuchi and Anishinabe. I'm from Oklahoma and I'm a leader with the Indigenous Environmental Network and the Rising Majority. It wasn't that many years ago, our people, the first peoples of this great country, could not legally vote. However, this year, the Indigenous people of this land turned the tide of the American vote and came out despite many challenges. We organized our community to show up, and the numbers don't lie. We did. We saw the largest voter turnout of Indigenous peoples in the history of the United States. And with our vote, we sent a message, a clear and present mandate for Joe Biden to no longer sacrifice our communities and the nations in the name of so-called progress. Here are three things that the Biden administration can do right now to respect Indigenous peoples and all those who got him into office. First, our votes came with a mandate for Joe Biden to build back fossil free and deliver jobs, justice, and opportunity for all. Right now, Biden can protect and invest in the Indigenous, Black, Brown, and working class communities and reject new fossil fuel projects, eliminate giveaways to oil, gas, and coal corporations, and end the era of fossil fuel production and false solutions to climate change. Second, from day one, we demand that Biden use his position to address the generations of harm, land theft, and violence imposed on Indigenous peoples of this land and begin the process of reconciliation following Indigenous leadership. Right now, Biden can take executive action to strengthen America's nation-to-nation relationship with tribal nations by making systemic changes to federal policies. He must honor the trust responsibility to American Indians, Alaska Natives, and Native Hawaiians with implementation across all government agencies and with specific attention to environmental and social justice. This includes requiring all federal agencies to obtain free, prior, and informed consent by tribal nations and Indigenous peoples when considering federal actions affecting their lands, livelihood, culture, and spirituality. Free, prior, and informed consent, FPIC, means free, being without coercion or force, prior, being before construction or implementation, informed with all important and relevant information, and consent being to give or not give permission. This is a shift from traditional business as usual federal policy. Biden must enforce the treaty agreements made with tribal nations and support their inherent self-governance. Biden must eliminate the so-called Montana rule and have Congress confirm that tribal nations can exercise their full authority over their own citizens, lands, resources, and activities within their tribal lands. And of great importance, we look to the Biden administration to implement the United Nations Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples without qualifications. Finally, Indigenous people need this presidency to be one that focuses on the real issues that are creating climate change and the chaos it's creating. So many Indigenous communities are dealing with the serious dangers of climate change. Now, we have no time to wait. Bold action must be taken to confront the climate chaos we are experiencing. Biden must reject all federal permits for fossil fuel and other climate-damaging infrastructure, including export facilities, refineries, the Dakota Access, Line 3, and Mountain Valley pipelines. This must be a presidency that refuses to rely on false solutions. The Paris Agreement is not enough to address climate chaos. Article 6 of the Paris Agreement is full of carbon credits, nature-based solutions, and other false solutions. The idea that net zero emissions can be met with carbon credits is rhetoric. Carbon credits are paid to pollute loopholes that allow big polluters to keep polluting. So we invite the Biden administration to reject any false solutions that do not hold polluters directly accountable for ending carbon pollution in its entirety. We the people, Indigenous, Black, Brown, Queer, and other oppressed people, got Trump out of office. We did this knowing full well who and what Biden was, a president who would attempt to negotiate with white supremacists and capitalists to find the middle group. Our people and the planet will not be casualties. Now that Joe Biden and Kamala Harris are in office, we want to be clear that our resistance must continue. San Lam, thank you.